The vestibular system can give us the velocity information.
I came to the university in 1993 doing a postdoc, and as my postdoc was wrapping up, the Department of Biomedical Engineering here was really getting off the ground, and I've taught every single student that's ever graduated with a biomedical engineering degree from this school. And that's been my honor and privilege.
When I first started teaching, I had a series of very purposeful choices, emphasizing the sense of community in my classroom, making students be excited about learning. Experiential learning is based on the belief that students learn best when they involve all kinds of sensors, and learning happens in many different ways. Community engagement is slightly different. It's also experiential, but it involves an element of mutually beneficial activities.
I'm very passionate for what I'm teaching, and I try to transfer that passion and enthusiasm to my students. They come in with a lot of energy, a lot of enthusiasm. For many of them, it's the first experience to do research in a laboratory. And so it's been great to see how they grow over the years and the time they spend in the lab, become better scientists, they become better thinkers.
I'm doing a little bit of online and in person. It is an unusual year for students. I've been very reflective about the idea that we're training the next generation of medical design manufacturers. These are the students that are going to help us get through this in the next 2, 3, 4 years.
I think remote learning taught me to be more caring and more attentive instructor and more flexible instructor. In certain circumstances where students now located far away or other circumstances, students with disabilities, for example, remote learning can be really useful.
One important component is really to involve undergraduate students in what are relevant research experiences. And that's very rewarding for them. It's very rewarding for us, and it helps also push our program forward.
It's wonderful that the university places such an emphasis on excellence in teaching. It's just fortuitous that the skills that I've developed over the last 4 or 5 years really came into play in the last couple of years.
This is an incredible recognition. It's a recognition of both sort of my role of a teacher here, but also of all the hard work and the enthusiasm that all the undergraduate students have brought to the lab over this year.
And there are so many wonderful teachers and so many great teachers that don't have a lot of opportunities to be recognized. So I think Goergen Award is just a wonderful way to keep us all focused on teaching as an important part of our identity as faculty.